In 1896, a young Cherokee named Jennie Ross Cobb became the first female Native American photographer. The great-granddaughter of Principal Chief John Ross, Jennie was raised in the Tahlequah and Park Hill areas of the Cherokee Nation in Indian Territory. Around the turn of the century, and with the development of consumer-level cameras and mobile photography technology, the craft was no longer limited to professionals. As photography became a popular hobby, the leading camera manufacturer, Kodak, marketed a successful advertising campaign toward women. It was during this era that Jennie received her first camera at the age of 6. Cherokee people have always been known as early adopters of new technology, especially during this time in our history. Jennie Ross Cobb's early interest in photography is further proof of that notion. This Bausch & Lomb camera belonged to Jennie. Before the advent of film, she developed the glass negatives herself in a retrofitted closet of the Hunter's home where she lived. Today, 21 prints of Jennie's original images are kept safe in the Oklahoma Historical Society's photo archives.
This is the Jennie Ross Cobb collection, and these are prints that were made from glass plate negatives that were taken by Jennie Ross Cobb, and that was between 1896 and 1906.
Jennie captured images of the world around her at a pivotal moment in time immediately preceding statehood in 1907, when Oklahoma absorbed the Cherokee Nation into its borders. In a time when the majority of outward-facing Cherokee representations were based off of stereotypes or falsehoods, Cobb's photos show real Cherokee people in their everyday lives. The disparities in representation are stark. Jennie Ross Cobb attended school at the Cherokee Female Seminary in what is now Tahlequah, Oklahoma. Many of her photos documented the daily lives of her fellow students, middle and upper-class young Cherokee women. When the railroad came to Tahlequah in 1902, Jennie and her friends were there to explore the Iron Road. Other photos depict a town carnival. Another is a timeless image of Cherokees enjoying watermelon slices on a summer day.
There's so much that goes into creating a quality glass plate negative. And every level of this creation, like the settings and the way she captured it, it ended up being a perfect balance and a perfect representation. You can see the detail and the depth in it, and that's part of what makes a great quality photograph, is that balance, you know, the light and contrast and everything.
In the 1950s, Jennie returned to her childhood residence, Hunter's Home, to advise the Oklahoma Historical Society on its restoration of the house. Its early architecture and furnishings had been recorded in photos by Jennie in the early 1900s, and it was these photographs that enabled an accurate restoration of the only surviving plantation home in the state. Now, more than a century later, at this historic site, Jennie Ross Cobb's legacy lives on.